Covered line directional coupler. Covered line directional coupler is another important type of directional couplers. It is based on a configuration called covered line transmission line. Usually, covered line transmission line is presented in the form of printed transmission lines like strip line or microstrip line. The configuration of covered line in strip line configuration is simply two conducting strips embedded between two ground planes, and these two ground planes are separated by a dielectric material with epsilon r, or with dielectric constant equals epsilon r. The spacing between the two ground planes is assumed to be P, and the width of the strips is assumed to be the same, W, and the separation between the two strips is S. Actually, this is a very special case. Other cases can be based on different widths of lines, for example, and also maybe the two lines may be not in the same level. However, this special case is the most popular case in coupled line, edge coupled strip lines. Another configuration is stacked or broadside coupled strip line. In this case, the two strips are coupled in vertical direction instead of horizontal direction. So, the two strips are located at different levels from the bottom ground plane. The separation between the two strips is assumed to be S, and the separation between the two ground planes is assumed to be B. Similar to the edge coupled strip line, there is coupled microstrip line, where two microstrip lines are printed parallel to each other, and these two strip lines are assumed to be printed on a grounded dielectric slab with dielectric constant epsilon r and dielectric thickness d. This is basically some configurations of coupled line or coupled lines. Before going on coupled line directional coupler, let us first discuss the basic theory of the coupled lines or coupled line transmission line. So in this video, we are going to discuss the basic theory of coupled line transmission lines, and in the following videos, we are going to discuss how to use this coupled line in designing a directional coupler. Also, coupled lines are a good candidate for the application of coupled line filters in bandpass filters, and this will be discussed in chapter 8. Okay, we are going to start with the analysis or quasi-static analysis of coupled line strip line, and we are going to start with each coupled strip line. For the case of coupled line strip line, edge coupled strip line, the equivalent circuit for the capacitance between the lines and the ground plane can be presented as a capacitor C11 between the first line and the ground plane. The ground plane here is assumed to be the combination of the two ground planes. Right, and C22 is the capacitance between the second strip and the ground plane. In addition to the capacitance of each strip with the ground plane, there is another capacitance between the two strips, which is the coupling capacitor or the coupling capacitance. This coupling capacitance is presented as C12, the capacitance from the first strip to the second strip. For the analysis of coupled line transmission line, we are going to apply the even odd technique which we have used in the analysis of the power divider, the retention power divider, for example. In even odd mode, we have two different configurations for the excitation of these two coupled lines. One configuration is that both lines have the same current in the same direction. This means that both lines will have the same potential at every point. In this case, we can analyze just a single line with the appropriate image wall. The appropriate image wall in this case is perfect magnetic wall, H wall. In H wall, the tangential magnetic field at this H wall would be zero. Or in other words, there is no current density is passing in this direction because the potential of this strip is the same as the potential of this strip in the even mode analysis. So there is no current passing from the strip 1 to strip 2, and as a sequence, the magnetic field at the mid plane between the two strips would be zero, or the tangential magnetic field at the mid plane between the two strips, it would be zero. This is equivalent to be presented as a perfect magnetic wall is presented at the midway between the two strips. For the even mode analysis, the potential on C11 is the same as the potential at C22. So the potential difference between C12, it would be zero. There is no potential difference between this point and this point. This means that the effect of C12, it will be zero because there is no current or there is no charging from the first strip to the second strip. So the total capacitance at strip 1 and the total capacitance at strip 2 in the even mode, it would equal the even capacitance CE. So the even capacitance CE would equal C11 would equal C22. That's assuming that the width of the strips will be the same. Okay. On the other hand, for a strip line, the phase velocity for even or odd modes would be the speed velocity of light over the square root of the dielectric constant epsilon r. And the relation between the characteristic impedance and the wave velocity is that the characteristic impedance equals 1 over the phase velocity multiplied by the capacitance. So in the case of the even mode, the even characteristic impedance, it would be the square root of LE over CE, the equivalent inductance for even mode over the equivalent capacitance for even mode, which can be presented as the square root of LE CE over CE. And the square root of LE CE is actually 1 over the phase velocity. And the phase velocity, either for the odd mode or the even mode, in the case of straight line, both of them are constant. And they equal C over epsilon r. The phase velocity in the case of straight line is C over square root epsilon r. So, in this case, the even characteristic impedance is simply 1 over the phase velocity multiplied by the even capacitance CE. And even capacitance CE here is the self capacitance of strip 1 or the self capacitance of strip 2. Okay? On the other hand, for the odd mode, we have equal currents in strip 1 and strip 2, but in different directions. This means that the potential at the first strip would be the negative value of the potential at the second strip. If the potential at the first strip is the negative of the potential at the second strip, this means that the electric field between the two strips will be normal at the midway or the midplane between the two strips. If the electric field is normal, it means that the tangential electric field is zero. This is equivalent to a perfect electric conducting wall. This is equivalent to a perfect electric conducting wall because the tangential electric field is zero and the field at the midway is completely normal. It's going from the strip 1 to strip 2 in normal direction. This perfect electric conducting wall in the circuit theory, it can be represented as a short circuit to the ground. And in this case, the capacitance C12 will have charging or charging current from line 1 to line 2. So there is some electric current will pass from the strip 1 to strip 2 through the coupling capacitance C2. If we are interested to separate the strip 1 from strip 2 and taking into consideration the effect of C12, we can represent C12 here by two capacitance in series, such that the total capacitance would equal the value of C12. And because the two strips are similar to each other, so these two capacitance should be equal. If they are equal and in series have the same value of C12, this means that the value of the first capacitance it would be twice C12 and the value of the second capacitance it would be twice C12. Now, if we are adding a short circuit to the ground plane, which is equivalent to the electric wall here, we are going to separate the circuit of the strip 1 from the circuit of the strip 2. And in this way, this separated circuit would be exactly equivalent to this complete circuit. So, the total capacitance seen by the first strip in this case, which corresponds to the odd capacitance, it would be C11 plus 2C12. And it should be noted, I'm looking from this point. So in this case, these two capacitance are in parallel to each other. So the total capacitance in this case is the summation of these two capacitances. In a similar way, the capacitance at the strip 2, would be the summation C22 plus twice C12. And because the two strips are of the same dimensions, are similar to each other, the odd capacitance of the first strip should equal the odd capacitance of the second strip. So the odd capacitance, C odd, would equal C11 plus 2C12, which equals C22 plus twice C12. Now, from the point of view of the characteristic impedance, the odd characteristic impedance would equal square root the odd inductance L naught over the odd capacitance C naught, which can be represented as the square root of L naught C naught over C naught. L naught C naught, or the square root of L naught C naught, equals 1 over the phase velocity. And as I said, the phase velocity either for the even or odd modes will be the same, because it depends on the configuration of the strip line, which equals c over square root epsilon r. This means that the odd characteristic impedance z naught o or z naught odd would equal 1 over the phase velocity multiplied by the odd capacitance c odd. So we have now even characteristic impedance and odd characteristic impedance. Based on these two impedance for the even and odd mode, we are going to design the directional coupler or the coupled filter or any circuit based on coupled lines. For the case of strip line, the relation between the even impedance and the odd impedance can be presented in a chart in this way. This chart, the x-axis equals the square root of epsilon r multiplied by the odd impedance, and the y-axis equals square root epsilon r multiplied by even impedance. And the chart itself, here it is moving as a function of the spacing between the two strips over the distance between the two ground plates, S over B. And here it is moving according to the value of the width of the strip over B. So, to design a specific coupled line or strip coupled line with a specific value of even impedance and odd impedance, we are going to determine the value of the square root epsilon r z odd, assuming that we know what is the dielectric material between the two ground planes. So we are going to determine the value of square root z naught odd, assuming that it is 80, for example, and the even characteristic impedance here. And from the intersection point, we are going to determine the required value of the width over B and the required value of the spacing S over B. So, by assuming the value of B, we can determine the width and the spacing is. Okay. This chart is general for strip line configurations. So regardless what is the value of epsilon r and what is the value of b, we can use this chart to design a coupled strip line configuration. For the case of microstrip line, the situation is different because the phase velocity is not constant as in the case of the strip line. This is due to the strip line is not completely filled with the dielectric material. So the phase velocity here depends on the dielectric constant of the slab as well as the free space above the strips or the microstrip structure. So, the phase velocity is not completely c over square root epsilon r. And in this case, we need to create designing a chart for the coupled line, transmission line, for every value of epsilon r. So, for coupled microstrip line, the result don't scale with dielectric constant. This means that the design graph must be made for a specific value for dielectric constant. For each value of epsilon r, we have a design chart. This figure shows the even and odd mode characteristic impedance for epsilon r equals 10. So, specifically here, the value of epsilon r is 10. This chart is not valid for another epsilon r, right? In a similar steps, we can design the coupled strip line, the coupled microstrip line in this case by determining the required value of the odd impedance and the required value of even impedance. Assume that we are talking about 80, for example, for the odd impedance and 120 for the even impedance. From the intersection point, we are going to determine the value of W over D and the value of S over D. Now, by assuming the value of D, we can obtain the value of W and the value of S. Alright, once again, this chart is valid only for epsilon r 10. For another epsilon r, we have other charts. Right? Another configuration for coupled line, instead of being coupled from the edge, it would be coupled from the broadside. Actually, this broadside coupling will increase the coupling capacitance C12, because in the case of the edge, the capacitance would be from the edge to the edge, but here the capacitance would be due to all the strip size. Assuming that the width of the strip line is very large with respect to the value of S, and also is very large with respect to the value of B, in this case we can approximately say that the capacitance will be obtained from the simple form of variable plate capacitor. And in this case, the capacitance per unit length, it would be epsilon multiplied by the width of the line over the distance, according to what I'm solving for. If I'm solving for the coupling capacitance between strip 1 and strip 2, the distance, it would be the value of S. If I'm solving for the capacitance between strip 1 and the ground plane, so in this case, it would be the distance, it would be B minus S, and this would be this distance and this distance, so over 2, B minus S over 2. So this distance is B minus S over 2. Also, if you are interested to obtain the capacitance between the second strip and the ground plane, the distance between the blade and the ground plane, it would be B minus S over 2. So, in this case, the value of C11 and C22, it would be epsilon naught epsilon r, where the relative permittivity of the medium between the two ground plane, multiplied by the width W over the distance, which is B minus S over 2. These two will be coming back to the numerator, so it would be 2 epsilon naught epsilon r W over B minus S. This is the value for C11 and C22. On the other hand, the coupling capacitance between the two strips, it would be epsilon naught epsilon r W over the distance between the two blades, which is S. Alright? And because this capacitance per unit length, so its unit is farad per meter. Now, once we determine the value of C11, C22, and C12, we can determine the even characteristic impedance Z not even and the odd characteristic impedance Z not odd, as we have done before for the edge coupled strip line configuration. Okay, this is briefly how to determine the even and odd characteristic impedance of strip lines and microstrip lines. In the following video, we are going to study how to use this coupled line configuration to design a coupled line directional coupler. Okay, all right. Here, C even as a completing for what we said, the even impedance is C11 and the odd impedance is C11 plus 2 C12. C11 here is 2 epsilon naught epsilon r w over b minus s. C11 plus 2 C12 is 2 epsilon naught epsilon r multiplied by w over 1 minus bs. This is C11 plus 1 over s. This is 2 C12. If we have the even impedance and odd impedance, and the phase velocity for the strip line is C over square root epsilon r, so the even characteristic impedance for the case of broadside coupled strip line, it would be 1 over the phase velocity Vb multiplied by the even capacitance Ce. Now, by using the phase velocity as C over square root epsilon r and the value of Ce as 2 epsilon r epsilon naught w over b minus s, so we can prove that the even impedance for broadside coupled strip line is b minus s over 2 w square root epsilon r multiplied by eta naught. Actually, this eta naught is going from the value of C is 1 over square root mu naught epsilon naught. So this is square root mu naught epsilon naught multiplied by square root epsilon r. And we have epsilon r in the denominator, so this would be square root epsilon r. And square root mu naught epsilon naught over epsilon naught in the denominator, it would be square root mu naught over epsilon naught, it would be eta naught. In a similar way, the odd impedance, the odd characteristic impedance, it would be 1 over the phase velocity multiplied by C odd. Phase velocity is C over square root epsilon r, and C odd is 2 epsilon r epsilon naught w multiplied by 1 over b minus s plus 1 over s. By using these two values, we can prove that the odd impedance for the broadside coupled line is eta naught multiplied by 1 over 2 w square root epsilon r multiplied by 1 over b minus s plus 1 over s. Okay, this is how to obtain the even and odd characteristic impedance for broadside coupled strip lines. See you in the next video in the designing of coupled directional coupler by using coupled transmission lines.